Hey guys, this is Pixel Dan, and you are watching the Mad Hunter channel right here on YouTube.
Let's find Skeletor and get him, right?
Yeah! Corre video. Estamos aquí relajándonos un poquito. Estamos aquí con el buen Arturo, mejor conocido como Jesus de Tijuana, Fisto de Tijuana,
The Beautiful,
el hermoso Jesús,
tu amante,
la Esmeralda. No. Bueno, estamos aquí con el Arturo, estamos aquí con el culo de Lole. El buen Edwin en la cámara. Vamos a mostrar un poquito de lo que estuvimos agarrando, ¿no?
Saca esa bolsita.
Buenas figuras.
Nunchucks.
Ahora, en este viaje se le bautizó al buen Arturo como Honey Tits. Y ya nos está tirando, ¿no? Qué asco. Mosquito.
El mosco, pues.
Agarrar el carrito. Y vean este. ¿Qué haces, cabrón?
Es que estoy bien nervioso. Un Horde Trooper.
Creo que estas figuras son algunas de las más buscadas de la línea, digamos, de lo común. Porque no salieron más que en Estados Unidos. Encontrar este tipo de piezas de repente es difícil y están completitas en buen estado. Entonces es el tipo de cosas que uno puede venir a PowerCon y aprovechar.
¿Qué vas a sacar ahora?
No, vas tú.
Ah, yo, no, ok.
En lo que va este güey, por eso les muestro otra comprita express que hice.
¡Morenazo!
Eso.
¿Cuánto?
Grislor de Veracruz y otro Horde Trooper con cómic.
Este fue un regalo. Coquetón, es un exclusivo.
¡Wow! Un exclusivo de Super 7, se lo regalaron.
Este también, Solo World. Real of the Underworld, también fue un regalo.
Pero algo vintage, ya te estás cambiando al otro bando.
Pero esos son regalos, son buenos detalles. Esta
Cherry,
esta que tiene caspa.
Yo le daría.
Las pelas.
O sea, yo le daría un 10 de AFA.
Caray. Es mint condition.
Es que la saliva de rata conserva el cartón.
No, de madreado.
eBay mint.
Fue un buen lotecito de armas, mira cómo no. Aquí complaciendo a la gente bonita para todos ustedes, aquellos que les hace falta un poquito de armas.
Sabemos que las armas son bien socorridas, ¿no?
Oh, este estuvo bueno. Miren nomás.
¿Qué es eso?
Super globo.
Caray.
Son globos, güey, como los que vendían en Veracruz, güey.
Esos matan las ballenas, por eso ya no los venden, Arturo.
Y un papel de baño de Skeletor, ¿no?
Ah, cabrón, ¿y este? Oh, este.
Ah, ese está muy bueno.
¿Ya vieron el pecho? Es como...
Ese pecho plateado.
Como plateado, ajá. Fíjense la... El contraste de las piernas, brazos al pecho. Aquí tenemos un Wielder con su llave maestra.
$15.
¡Qué barato!
$35.
Trap Joe.
¿Este que es México?
México.
Ah, esta es buena variante. Trap Joe México de Mavamex.
Esta también es una buena variante. El
Pink Armor.
Salmón. Pechera salmón.
¿Puedo mostrar lo que yo conseguí? Eso, conseguí un C-3PO tipo sexy comedia. Es una variante muy exclusiva. Incluye una pieza de Mossman, así de overstock.
Miren a quién nos encontramos aquí, es Pixel Dan.
Hey guys, what's up?
It's very cool to meet you.
But hey, I'm glad I got to meet you, man.
No, it's really a pleasure. I really appreciate what you do and the way you do your things, you know.
Like, yeah.
I also have a YouTube channel.
I have seen some of your stuff. I'm excited. I'm really excited about what you're about to show me, too.
Nice. Bueno, le dije que lo quería invitar un poco a que viera las piezas de Los Amos y el bootleg que trajimos. Are you into bootlegs?
Oh, yes. I'm into it.
Let's go.
All right, let's do it.
In Mexico, in the 80s, we had a toy factory called Orimat that produced the Masters of the Universe, 28 figures. Uh-huh. But then Mattel opened another factory, but more like American factory by Mattel, gotcha, in Tijuana. And most of the figures marked Mexico were made there just to sold on the U.S.
Oh.
But people think like, oh, those are Mexican. No, those were packed in the U.S. and made with USA accessories.
Oh, wow.
So it's weird because when you want to complete the figure is marked Mexico, uh-huh, but the weapons says USA.
Oh, wow.
These were made only in Mexico and they were packed in boxes. These are like the six Holy Grails from the Mexican collection. Trap Jaw with the many faces arm.
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
But look at the face. Also, the sculpture changed, the nose.
That's amazing. I love the face on this one.
Yeah.
It's almost like it's pointier.
Yes.
And I don't know. I love that.
Are you ready for the next one?
All right, let's do it.
Look at the weapon.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Jitsu's katana.
Yeah, it's the katana. Done in purple instead of orange. Amazing.
Clawful. With the pink.
So he's got, oh, it's like pink. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
This one's very rare, for example. I've been collecting for more than 15 years and I only have two, mine and this one that I brought extra, you know, like.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That is cool. Yeah, I didn't even know that was a thing. It's amazing.
One of my favorite characters, White Mouth Cobra Khan.
Oh, yeah. Huh. It's amazing just to see all the different variations of these just from around the world. That's mind-blowing to me. And it's impressive that, like, you know how to pick all this stuff out.
Like, what do you think about, like, lately collectors are getting into, like, foreign variation? For example, me, I'm from Mexico and I love these, but I also am into Top Toys from Argentina.
Yes.
Into Leo from India. Have you seen that Faker from Leo?
Yeah, the Leo Faker, of course. Well, some of those are almost like legend at this point, right? Like, yeah. I've always wanted to have a Black Blood Mosquito. I think it's one of those things where, especially now, like, everybody's collected pretty much everything from their childhood toy line, so they're looking for new things to go out and collect.
I think that's why the bootleg,
and that's why the bootleg stuff started getting popular. It's also why I think like the Remco stuff got real popular, and you know, because when we were kids here in the U.S., those were all like kind of the knockoff toys, and we didn't really buy that stuff. Now everybody wants that stuff, you know. I have seen the Speculatrons. They're amazing.
Yeah.
The Death Lore, I think, right? Is he the purple skull with the glitter?
With the glitter.
He's amazing.
Give me your opinion about some of these weird things we have here.
Look at this. What are these? Spank throw. They look like almost like Flintstone cars.
It's a Playmobil.
That is unreal. Just a little Thundercats sticker on.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
just
good
to make
stuff.
Sure it's a Thunder thing.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Is that a Shredder on like a
Shredder? Look at the arms and the legs.
Dial.
Yeah, they use like kind of a human body and make a Shredder.
Yeah, they like added little spikes to the shoulders and the shins. Oh my gosh. I would buy a whole line of these if they did turtles like all in the human body stuff.
Yeah,
style.
What I also like about bootlegs is that the history behind them, they were made for children without you know, the economic thing to buy the original.
Right.
So someone came up and said like, let me do a Skeletor that can cost 10 times less.
Yeah.
But they were creating it maybe in a garage in a very small amount.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, totally.
So that's what makes them rare right now.
I love the dark blue that they used on this one too. That's looking sweet. Oh yeah, I like this man at arms too.
Yeah.
Oh,
you have a good taste.
Good taste.
It's like the Skittles promo.
Skittles.
Now, I'm very happy you're here. I just want to like ask you, which is your favorite toy line? I know it's a very hard question, but
my favorite toy line, just like all time toy line, it's definitely the vintage Masters of the Universe.
Wow.
I do like Star Wars. So like I got into collecting Star Wars late in my childhood, so like my first real Star Wars figures were in 95 when like that line came out. I totally missed the vintage stuff as a kid. I don't know why. Ninja Turtles, I was way into Ninja Turtles too, so those are like my top twos right there, He-Man and Turtles.
Do you like Hot Wheels?
Hot Wheels? I had a bunch of Hot Wheels, but I was never like big into collecting them.
It was very nice meeting you. I recommend his channel for everybody who's watching.
Thank you very much.
The difference of my channel is that it's only vintage, but yeah. When you review things, I enjoy them and I don't have to buy them
there
anymore.
There we go. Yeah, I hear that a lot actually, which is really cool. But that's great. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And you guys all need to subscribe to this channel too. You got something going on here that not a lot of other people have access to. So this is great.
Thank you very much. Lola se vino a encontrar con otro argentino aquí, pero vean nada más quién es Axel Jiménez.
Axel Jiménez.
Y nos estaba compartiendo un poco de su trabajo. Cuéntanos un poquito, Axel, ¿qué me ibas a mostrar?
Esto es una portada que hice para Guerreros del Mañana, que se está publicando en Argentina.
¿Este es de la 1 o de la, del cómic 1 o del cómic 2?
El número 2.
Mira, sí ubico este.
Y estoy por empezar el número 3, la portada del 3, cuando vuelva.
Excelente trabajo. Qué increíble, ¿eh? Te felicito porque tienes toda como la esencia de lo vintage, de lo retro, que es lo que a mí me gusta.
Sí, es lo que me gusta también.
Muchos de los nuevos dibujantes ahora, yo no los pelo en realidad porque veo que como que cada uno le quiere dar su toque y está bien. Sí. Pero acaban un poco como con lo que es el personaje vintage, ¿no? Vean Skeletor, o sea, es la esencia de lo retro. O sea, tú todo lo dibujaste.
Sí.
Wow. Arte
todo bien.
Wow.
O sea, cuando tú ahora te compras un Ultimate, este sería como el supuesto mini cómic.
Claro, es lo que
está dentro.
Y tú estás trabajando con Super 7, o sea, las portadas, los empaques de Super 7 están diseñados por ti.
Sí, incluso la nueva ola de figuras que va a haber de Classics y los de Filmation también, van a tener miedo.
Wow, te felicito en verdad.
Gracias.
Ahorita si quieres regreso para lo del He-Man. Vamos a hacer una de las negociaciones fuertes de este fin de semana. Tuve que sacar, pero hasta los bootlegs. El domingo es un día muy relajado, pero es un día donde también puedes agarrar tus cosas. Todo el mundo se anda cambiando entre esto y esto. Está la cultura de que el domingo es como para intercambiar esto. Entonces, bueno, vengo.
I'm very happy that we kind of make a deal, not only with cash, also with some Mexican pieces.
Quiero mostrarles un poco esto. Here it is, the G.I. Joe, the swords, the slide. And the 12 pounds of my money shot. Yo me llevé igual unas piezas prototipos. Lo que quería era como que, bueno, obtener un descuento. Como si él me comprara eso. Y así yo no le doy solo cash, ¿no? Sino que, bueno, nos llevamos un bow, como pueden ver aquí, con dos armaduras, una rosa y otra color carne. Me encantó. De hecho, este tiene la pelvis de She-Ra. Me llevé un híbrido que tiene el pecho de She-Ra con cabeza de Catra. Igual, otra pieza, otra test shot prototipo de la fábrica. La pieza espectacular, que es el Rock-On, que dejé el año pasado, que ahora no se me iba vivo. O sea, esta figura, se los juro, desde el año pasado quería regresar por ella para que esté junto con su compañero. El módulo, que bueno, este módulo, lo más raro que tiene son estas cuatro piezas que igual son test shots, unproduced colors. Y las otras partes, yo no les veo ninguna diferencia. Muchas veces podían ser de producción o no, nada más como para hacer la pieza. Y él me hizo un obsequio, that you make me a gift. Thank you very much. Fíjense qué coincidencia, porque entre el lote de prototipos y cosas que él encontró, venía esta pieza de Snoke's Boat, del elefante, y es transparente. Como saben, I really love all the clear stuff.
This just meant whatever color was in the machine, they shot it through, whether it's blue, purple, or clear. When they wanted to do a test shot, this just happened to have clear, which makes it really rare because they don't always shoot clear.
Yeah,
I know. And clear sometimes has a different feel. It's a little softer. Yeah. Right. So that makes it even special, even more special. But it's a gift, not for sale. A gift to you.
For me, this is very special, Scott. Thank you very much. Ese es como mi regalito. Estas son otras piezas que, bueno, ya fueron como el piloncillo, que es un Horde Trooper, un Snoke's Boat también. Y bueno, lo interesante de esto es que ya con el deal y con cosas así, pude negociar esta como cajita de piezas que, bueno, ya al llevarme esas dos, como que valía la pena
tenerlas todas igual. Son pruebas de la fábrica, son dos cabezas de bow, varios escudos en diferentes colores, las armaduras de los caballos y algunas piernas. Entonces vamos a armar ahí un set con esas dos figuras de Princess of Power tremendo. Before we quit this, can you show me again the portfolio? El año pasado conocimos al... last year we met some of your friends that were at your booth. You were not here, but I'm very happy because you explained me more about the former Mattel employee.
Yeah.
Could you tell us a little bit more about
Alan him? Tyler, he worked for the different toy companies throughout the 80s. He went to Pasadena College Art and Design, graduated 79. By 83, he was working for Mattel. By 86, he was working for Hasbro, and then he was a freelance throughout the 90s. He did toy design, he did hologram design, he did industrial makeup and mechanical designs for theme parks. He did a lot of work, and he was a very creative fellow.
That's him there, sculpting, yeah.
Man, I guess that it. What was his complete name?
Alan Tyler.
Alan Tyler. Vean todo lo que en lo que él como iba trabajando, Mad Scientist.
This toy line I like the most because it's the most direct representation of his artwork.
Right.
His artwork style from start to finish to making the toy looks exactly how he draws. These are test shot holograms basically. Oh, there's a hologram here too.
It's his card.
Yeah.
Alan Tyler in Hasbro.
Yeah.
It's him, right?
That's him again. He did all types of work. He worked for Star Trek for a while.
Star Trek?
Yeah. Ooh. Doing the makeup stuff. He made this giant Frankenstein bust. I still have the mold for that. It's pretty neat.
That's nice.
Did lots of special effects, hair routing, sculpting, painting.
And it's amazing to have all these photo sequence because you can like revive, you know, his work and all.
It shows his work. I mean, he's passed away, so this is nice that people get to see it. This is for Babylon 5 right there.
Babylon 5.
Yeah.
Star Trek, the Klingons over here.
I paint, I draw, but I don't sculpt.
No.
He could sculpt, paint, and draw.
Scott, thank you very much for this deal. You're an awesome guy. All the history behind the things you do and what you do for this hobby is amazing.
I know these pieces are going to a good home. You're going to catalog it. You're going to display it. You're going to really enjoy this. And not just, I'm going to flip it on eBay next week and make more money. This is a passion of yours, and I'm glad to give you some of that passion.
Thank you very much again. Now let me make my money shot. Hashtag de LOL del día de hoy es cumbia, nena. ¿Por qué no haces ahora un género nuevo que se llame cumbia punk?
No, porque me salgo a calle y me asesina.
Bueno, pues aquí termina PowerCon 2017. Estamos listos para la que viene y la que viene. La verdad la pasamos increíble, fue un evento fenomenal. Espero lo hayan disfrutado junto con nosotros y pues no me queda nada más que decirles que están viendo Mad Hunter Channel y pues aquí mis buenos colegas y partners in crime. ¿Cómo la pasaron? ¿Bien?
Pues el Eternia Cartel con todo este fin de semana, ¿eh?
Eso.
¿Todo bien? Excelente, excelente. Excelente evento, excelente camaridad.
Lole, Very hard.
Besos a la gente.
Very hard.
Besos a todos. Hay que besar a la gente.
Es correcto, ¿no?
Eso fue todo. Cuídense, vámonos.
El amor es el camino.